Well, 68-69, Mr. Brahmanand Reddy was the chief minister. Mr. Narasimha Rao was a part of the cabinet at that time. And that is the time when the Milky Rule issue came up. But I think essentially this Milky Rules were something that the Nizam had given. This is to safeguard the interest of the local people. Native. Mulki is native people. Then, as a part of the gentleman's agreement in 1956, also it was clearly specified that the after a period of 12 years, the people who have migrated from Andhra and settled in Hyderabad will be treated as local people. So then the competition for employment, education, whatever facilities one person would have as a local person would get diluted because it was going to end. So that really is part of...
Whether it happened or not happened, there was a feeling built up in Telangana that Andhra log aake so kha rahe. So, feeling developed.
I remember I had gone to Bangalore. On my way back, I traveled by train. Those days, flight air connectivity was also very limited. Long waiting lists. I managed to come by train. And then I informed my parents that I'm coming back by train and would arrive in Kachigur. So when I came out of the station, I expected my car to be there to pick me up. There was no car. It was very difficult for me to contact them. They couldn't inform me in advance. On that day, I found that the entire streets of Hyderabad, from Tarnaka to Kachiguda station, it was littered with stones, with electric poles, with all kinds of obstructions. So nothing could move. The entire city had come to a standstill. So there were many episodes like this during that prolonged period of Telangana agitation.
See, that dissent actually was across. Okay, it was true in terms of Telangana because it was also very strong in Telangana because, you know, that merger was artificial. Okay, so cultural factors and other things were there. But you can compare that with Bihar, for instance. Karpuri Thakur, for the first time, was able to actually lead in Bihar a huge movement of the backward caste. And Nehru himself was threatened. Okay, so the dissent was brewing across because that euphoria that Nehru thought that industrialization would automatically absorb the surplus labor from rural and agricultural into the industry did not happen. Neither land reforms was successful. Nehru's idea was, if there is more agricultural produce, that surplus that is generated here would go into the industry, and industry would actually generate a lot of employment and labor would actually get employed here. None of these chains actually worked. And that's what we call in economics actually failure of the trickle-down theory.
Indiraji doesn't want this Andhra Pradesh to be divided at any cost. At any cost, come what, let 100 people die. I don't care. I don't want to divide the state. Brahmananda Reddy bungled it. This Telangana agitation. He arrested Chennareddy. He has put him in Rajahmundry jails.
The Congress High Command thought that, you know, having a chief minister from the Telangana region would probably placate the opinion in Telangana.
Telangana man, not Andhra man as chief minister.
At that time, there were probably many contenders. But then somebody who is acceptable to all the regions, somebody who is acceptable across the board of the Congress Legislature Party, as well as the important leaders, both here as well as in the center. When people looked for, the High Command looked for, and the state Congress leaders looked for a figure who could command the respect of all sections of the party and from all the regions, and it was Narasimha Rao.